In engineering subjects, so many subjects we are having in the first year. So irrespective of the branch specialization, the one of the most common subject is engineering drawing. So nowadays it is also called engineering graphics. So it's a very important as an engineer important to him. So every university had taken as the compulsory course in the first year introduction courses. So engineering drawing related to the subject. So as the name of the title itself, it is coined by engineering as well as drawing. So today we will discuss whatever the subject definition and what is the signification and how it is important to the any branch of engineer. So let me consider the first definition of our subject. We are considering, as I said, it is a kind of engineering and drawing. So everyone, as we know, the drawing, the childhood from onwards, the before we have started our academic learning, so we are focusing the drawing. So irrespective of this, the school introduction, the any child, as he get any pencil or pen, he use it to just draw any something, rough sketches or lines on a paper. He won't find that integers makes to the spoil a beautiful walls also sometimes. So that means, so drawing is nothing but actually what is mean drawing we have to consider. So drawing is a representation of anything we are getting in our mind so that we can put on the paper. So that is a drawing. So as a conventional way, so we can consider, so drawing as nothing but an art of representing. So wherever the art of the representing, we are hiring towards the engineering requirements. The engineering requirements means, as you know that today's, the so many specializations are there. So based on their study, they may be become professionals of their respective engineering skills. So good examples we can consider the surrounding, whatever you're having in the society as a civil engineer. So what the responsibility of the civil engineer? As a professional knowledge, he trying to represent a good plan so that we can construct a good beautiful buildings or sometimes the higher level, the dams and bridges and everything will be taken care of by the civil engineer. Similarly, whereas a mechanical engineer, he has to utilize the professional skills to make any machine component towards his field of requirements. Automobile engineers care of his domain as the automobile manufacturing designs. And like that, and every branch of the professionals has to utilize. So drawing as their instrumental communication towards the field of application. So that's why already we are told it is nothing but engineering and drawing. So drawing is an art of representation. Whereas engineering requirements, the engineering is a word generated by a Latin word ingenious. So ingenious nothing but an innovative or creative. We can just like that synonym words of meaning we can create. So whatever the field of application for innovative ideas, so we are using to represent so that we can communicate. So wherever the field of requirement, so that is the importance of our engineering drawing. So overall we can define the drawing as art of representation. As engineering is nothing but, as we said, actually it is a generated word from Latin ingenious. So that speaks the technological innovation or creative. So indirectly we can say, as overall, it is a technical application we can to meet our understanding. So art of representation towards the technical requirements is nothing but engineering drawing. So overall we can define the engineering drawing is nothing but a drawing drawn by an engineer having the technical knowledge to meet the purpose of engineering requirements. So for the good engineer, the drawing in his mind as an imaginary scenery or any other art cannot be said as an engineering drawing. So what does the engineering drawing mean? He has to represent having the knowledge of the technical to meet the purposes of engineering. The civil engineer has to just given a beautiful plan. Architectural engineer to give the good elevation or any interior design drawings. Or mechanical engineer, so like the machine components. A chemical engineer, any reactor drawings. Any electronics and communication engineer, so he may be just develop the any integrated circuit, the layout diagrams, so to meet the electronic instruments. The such are the applications of the professional skills of engineering. So that's why the such a thing, the drawing to meet his professional requirements, then only it's said to be the engineering drawing. So once again repeating the definition, engineering drawing is nothing but a drawing drawn by a technical person having the engineering knowledge to meet the purposes of engineer.
As we are discussing, just now we are finished whatever the definition of engineering drawing. So it is how it is important to every branch of engineering also we discussed. The one question we are left, so that is the computer science engineers, it is compulsory to their field of application or not. So many students the doubt that, so being it is not requirement to prepare any drawings as like a mechanical or civil or any other engineer, so there may students that stress that it is not that much important. So but we are awareness that every field of application, so now there is the role of computer increasing the just day to day as we are advancing. The similarly, a mechanical engineer has to utilize the computer related things in the field of his profession. It may be civil engineers, they may use their profession of the requirements. So but it is once made available as a programmable software, so then only they can use. So but what is the, who is the responsibility to made availability of the software? So then question comes, the answer is certainly the computer science engineers only. But when the computer science engineer has to just prepare a good software to available make end application by the mechanical engineer or civil engineer or aeronautical, this one, so any branch of specialization. So until unless he is not having the knowledge of the drawing, he may not be just make the available of the good software to make use by the respective professionals. So hence it is the very as the important to the every mechanical or civil engineer, it is equal important to the computer science engineers also. So they may hide at a good position in the some auto desk like that, any the background of mechanical application softwares preparing companies. So they compulsory they check the knowledge of the drawing. So once you have the knowledge of the drawing, we can just represent a good softwares to make utilization. So that way, irrespective of the branch of specialization, it is a compulsory had to study the first BTech level. Every student has to learn the concepts of the engineering drawing. So next come to the other features, the features of the engineering drawing. So what are the features of the engineering drawing? So one of the feature we can say that every engineers like that, we can just simple example, being the doctor, we are just in the society, we are commonly across the every individual may be experienced the constructing the houses. So how they can construct the house? So as they have the own some open plot area, they may approach a civil engineer. So that civil engineer that takes the very important inputs, this what is the independent house or multi-storied building. So like that he takes the inputs from us and try to represent his professional skills in a good plan manner. So as the plan we are acquiring, it will be executed by whom? So not the engineer being the prepared a plan by the engineer comes and construct everything of our building. But actually who is the construction? So generally in observe, just a master civil supervisor or normally we are called as a mason. So normal mason, by taking the layman labor people, we try to execute the same building as our wish, just prepared by a plan as an engineer. So how it is possible, even the engineer is not coming directly to the construction field, it can be executable. How it is mean? Whatever the engineer takes from inputs as us, it just be presented as a good plan. So that plan will be executed by who understood the plan given by the engineer. So that mean in one way, the engineer replaces his professional. So by giving a the simple plan, who understands the plan and execute the same way as our wish. So it is possible indirectly. So whatever the professional, he tries to communicate his ideas to other person who are able to read the drawing. So indirectly we are replacing a professional, so we are keeping the knowledge at a higher level only. So where is the low level, the normal people only, we are able to execute the things. So what it happens by taking this as our summary of example, the engineer can communicate his ideas through a plan so that it is executable directly as his wish. Similarly, a mechanical engineer, he may be take a good machine component and just ask to a workshop person, without his presence also, we are able to produce the same thing to understand. So what the thought of a mechanical engineer. So indirectly what it says, we are able to communicate, so his ideas, it can be executable as our wish. So it is nothing but a communication mode. So that's why it is known as communication language. So it's known as a engineering drawing is nothing but a language of engineers. So we have meet for communication. So it can be known as engineering drawing is the language of engineers. So any language, so what are the purpose of the language? Same as the language, how we are helps to communicate each another, to share whatever the requirement. Same similarly, the professional skills can be communicated to the other person by using the engineering drawing. So that's why one of the feature, it is nothing but language of engineers. The second feature of this one is any across the globe. Suppose the art, we can say just now, it is nothing but drawing. The drawing is nothing but art of the representation. Suppose any person asks you to represent a sun. How will represent normally? Just drawing a circle to represent the sun. If you are having the a little artistical mind, you may be added some rays like a lines, so that a decorative manner you can represent a sun. But overall, what you are able to draw sun representation mean? Definitely you draw a circle only, not a triangle or square. Similarly, you can just move the globe anywhere, like other country, China or Japan. The language style may be different, but any child also ask you to represent the sun. How will represent a sun? Not a triangle or not the other, any other polygon. You just try to represent as the same as a circle only. If there is adding a shiny rays, may be there. So that means irrespective of the anywhere you can move the globe, the representation is doesn't changes. So that's why it is universally represented everywhere same. So that's why it is known as the universal language. The drawing also known as universal language, being the representation doesn't changes with respect to place to place. So these are the features of the drawing. So one way it is a communication mode of an engineer. So that's why it is known as engineering drawing is the language of engineers. So other thing, irrespective of the any corner on the globe, the representation basically doesn't changes. So that's why it is also known as the universal language. So it is just outline of our engineering drawing related definition. How it is utilized, already you learned, it utilizes to communicate the professional skills to other person so that it can be executable as a professional requirement. So any drawing preparation, so we can made by hand also. But by the hand, what the problem is? So whenever the complex drawing or whenever the accuracy is the priority, so we cannot perform by making the hand sketches. So that's why we have to rely on the drawing instruments. So drawing instruments only to make us to prepare a drawing in the better accuracy level, so that and whenever complex drawing we want to prepare with the minimum time, we are able to represent the good accuracy.